This video is brought to you by Motion VFX. It's no accident Hayley Chamberlain is one of the biggest female tech channels on YouTube. Her channel, Hayls World, has over 160 million views and almost 2 million subscribers. Growing a channel this big takes a lot of hard work, dedication, and of course, exceptional editing. Today, we'll take a look at a few editing techniques Hayley uses in her videos and how you can replicate them in Final Cut Pro. The first technique we'll take a look at today is tracked callout titles. With Final Cut Pro's built-in object tracker, this is super simple to do. With your clip down in your timeline, go to the video inspector, and all the way down at the bottom, click the small plus button beside trackers. In the viewer window, adjust the tracker mesh over the object you want to track. Click the analyze button in the top left corner to track your clip. Next, go to the Titles and Generators browser and select the title you want to use for this. This can be one of Final Cut Pro's built-in titles or a third-party title, like this lower third callout from Motion VFX's M Tutorial plugin. Add this title above your video clip, replace the text, and adjust the title's appearance. Select the Transform tool and click the down arrow beside the Tracker button. Open the Tracker dropdown and select the object track from before. Open the Tracker dropdown again. Deselect rotation, and if necessary, in the video inspector, change your rotation value back to zero. All the tracking data from the clip below is applied to this title, so it moves perfectly with your tracked object. Another element you often see in Hayls World videos is animated Scribble highlights. There's a few plugins out there I like using for this. If you just want simple animations, have a look at the MZAP plugin. This plugin comes with over 100 comic animations that are great for highlighting and drawing attention to a specific part of your video, and they're super simple to use. For example, to draw attention to the subscribe button, let's add an arrow pointing to it. Skim over some of the presets to preview them, and once you find the one you like, connect it above your timeline. Use either the on-screen controls or the controls in Inspector to resize and place this animation in the right spot. Also, it's kind of hard to tell when the cursor clicks a button. Let's highlight it. Place your playhead on the frame of the action, find the animation you want to use, and add it above your timeline. Adjust the size, position, and timing of this animation and lead your viewer to look exactly where you want them to. I also like using MAnimes apps for this. This plugin comes with over 50 presets that are quite a bit more specific. You get energy animations, lightning, smoke, and more. And these are quite a bit more customizable. Take this lightning one for example. Besides the ability to change the size and color of the scribble, you can change the replicator shape, radius, replicator points, and much more. Plus, you have way more controls over the colors and glow of your animation. Now, I'm not exactly sure which plugins are used on Hayley's channel, but they're very similar to the ones I just showed you. If anyone from her team is watching this, please let us know in the comments below. Next up is the animated picture-in-picture effect, jumping from one side of the screen to the other. For this, you'll need a couple plugins, also from Motion VFX. You'll need the free M Motion Blur plugin and MTuber 3. Down in the timeline, we have an A-roll clip with some B-roll connected above it. To add a picture-in-picture window over your B-roll, select the MTuber 3 plugin and find the corner screen 2 preset. Grab this preset, add it above your timeline, and ripple trim it to the length you want. Move your playhead to the start of your title clip, go up to the video inspector, and click the drop zone button. Zoom right in on your timeline, make sure your skimmer is on the exact frame your playhead's on, and click the A-roll clip to select it for your drop zone image. Click apply clip. Now, to make this look like Hayley's picture-in-picture, use the on-screen controls to move it over to the left side of the screen and make it bigger. Go to the Titles Inspector, deselect the background element, turn on Frame Outline, and bring up Frame Width. Scroll down to the bottom, select the Drop Shadow checkbox, and increase the distance for more depth. Move your playhead to where you want to start your animation, and add keyframes to content position and scale. Go to the video inspector and add a keyframe to the opacity slider here. Move your playhead about 3 or 4 frames ahead and use the on-screen controls to make this window nice and small and move it over to the bottom center of your screen. Bring the opacity slider down to about 50%. Move 3 or 4 more frames ahead, bring the opacity back up Make the picture window the same size as before and move it over to the right side of the screen. Press Ctrl V to open the video animation bar. Move your playhead back to the first set of keyframes. Go back up to the Titles and Generators browser, navigate to M Motion Blur, and add the regular motion blur preset above your timeline. Ripple trim the end to your last set of keyframes. Render out your timeline for this cool animated picture-in-picture effect. This was just three of the many cool editing techniques used for Hayley's videos. I'll link her channel below. Great content and a ton of editing inspiration. If you like this type of content, I put together a short playlist that focuses on editing techniques of popular YouTubers. Click right here to watch it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you back here in the next one.